Today we're going to be looking at colorizing black and white photographs. We're going to start with an image like this and make it look like this. This same technique can be applied to any ethnicity. Now, recently in, I think it was Photoshop 2020, a filter was released under the filter Neural Filters, which allows you to colorize black and white photographs at a single click. Now, I'll just show you that in process. So if I go to Filter, Neural Filters, and once it's loaded up, choose Colorize down here, and you have an opportunity here to make a few adjustments to that colorization process. You can see the results are absolutely stunning. This is using AI technology to colorize this black and white image. However, it's not always going to work. The AI technology is getting better and better, but it doesn't always do a great job. Today I'm going to show you how to manually color a black and white image using adjustment layers. And I've actually created an action which you can get from the description below. If you just follow the description, you'll find a link to the action. If you install this Photoshop action, you'll be able to very easily hand tint or colorize your own black and white images within a couple of minutes. And let me show you now how that works. Right, so we have our image here, black and white image, as you can see from the layer stack. Just plain black and white, there's no layers whatsoever on there. I'm going to go to Actions, and then choosing my Colorize BW, that's the action group there. Inside there you'll find Colorize. So if I just click on that to select it and then press Play, what will happen now is a number of layers are going to be generated and applied to this image. So if I go to the layer stack now, you can see that a number of adjustment layers within groups have been generated. So we should have components, hair, and adjustments. Now the adjustments one, by the way, that's for global changes afterwards. So once you've applied all of your colorization, you can then go through the layers, go through these adjustment layers and just tweak, you know, tweak the saturation levels, the warmth, the coolness of the image. So we'll look at that later. Okay, so how quick is this to do? You can see here that the components group of adjustment layers, we have skin, lips, teeth, eye white, blue, eyes, brown eyes, eyelids, eye pink and gums, skin blush. So if I just choose one of these, I'm gonna go for skin, and I'm gonna make sure I've got a brush selected. On the tool palette, just hit B for brush, and that will bring up your brush, making sure that white is my painting color. And I'm going to right click and choose a hardness of 0. Make sure you choose a nice soft round brush for this. If I start painting with 100% opacity, you can see that I'm adding my skin tones. Now I'm going to paint the entire model here. So I'm going to include her shoulders, any areas of skin, including hair, eyes, lips, teeth, eye white, pretty much all of her. I'm going to paint with the skin adjustment layer. Now I can always toggle between black as my color just to remove any bits where I've gone over. See, I'm being quite liberal with the brush. I'm not being too careful. To toggle between black and white, all you need to do is press the X on your keyboard. There I go. I think that will do for now. Okay, moving on to the next one, lips. Now I'm going to zoom in a little for this. Bring in my brush size down using my parenthesis keys, black as my paint. I'll start painting those lips in. Like, for a bit of a better blend, I'm just going to bring the opacity down to 20%. And again, with white as my color, just a tiny bit over the edge there, just so it doesn't look too stark. Perfect. Okay, teeth. Going back to 100% opacity, I'm using my numerical keys to choose the opacity levels of my brush. I'm just going to paint the teeth. Now, very, very subtle. You can hardly see it. It's just a drop in saturation and a very slight amount of yellow in. Eye white, again, 0 to 400% on opacity. I'm just going to tap away at the eye whites there. Very subtle, hardly see the difference. I think I might give her blue eyes. Avoiding the centre of the eye, just tapping around the cornea. And then how about we skip one, let's go to eyelids. For this I'm going to go for 50% opacity and I'm going to paint around her eyelid. Blend that in a little, toggling between black and white using the X. Bring up the opacity just for the finer point, like so. And now she's starting to look like she's got a cold. Maybe I should just push that back a little bit in here. Okay, eye pink and gums. So the little bit here in the eyes and of course gums. Can't really see her gums in this particular case. So I'll just go for the eye pinks. White as my colour so that I'm adding colour. 100% opacity. And I'm just going to paint in the corners of the eyes and around where the eyelid meets the eye. Just be careful it doesn't go too over the top like it has there. There, that's starting to look real. Skin blush. If you look at your face, you're not just one colour. You've got various shades going on. Like around the nostrils, for instance, there's a bit of pink. So I've added skin blush to allow you to just capture some of those variances. And again, toggling between the X, between the black and the white with the X key, just so you can control. You go slightly over the top. If it doesn't look right, you can push it out again with the X key on black. There we are. Still think she's looking a little ill. Maybe I need to bring those eyelids just back out a little bit. Yeah, that's better. Right, hair. So let's move on. Let's collapse this folder for a second, this group, and we'll go on to hair. I think I'll just give her brown hair. 100% white with the brush, and I'm just painting over her hair. Brown hair is just a desaturated hint of the skin tone. So once I've done all that, if I feel it's looking a little grey, I can always double click here on the hue and saturation adjustment layer. And then just bring the saturation in until it looks the correct shade. I could even push it the other way if I wanted it to go very bright orangey red. Maybe something like that. Right, okay. Starting to get there. Maybe now I'll go to the adjustments and just see if I can get a little more out of this. So maybe if I boost the vibrance up a little, saturation maybe. How about colour balance? Maybe we could bring this one up. I could either cool it down a little bit, like that, or even warm it up a little. Curves. Now in the curves, the two areas that I've been really working with, two curves I've been working with, is the blue. So I wanted the shadows to become slightly cooler than the highlights, which are a little on the yellow side. And then under the... let's see now, which one was it? The red channel. I did the opposite. I brought the reds down in the shadows and then either stabilize the red in the highlights or even bring it up a little. So you've got almost a film effect on that. Now, I have to admit, that is not as good as the AI in this particular case. We've only spent a couple of seconds on it. There is plenty more that I could do with this, but the AI doesn't work in every single case. So in certain instances, you really want to be able to go into your image and manually hand tint it. Now, hopefully this action will be very useful for you for just generating those general skin tones and components, which you can then drop on to colorize your image. If you've liked this video, don't forget to hit the like, please subscribe. And if you are subscribed, hit the notification bell. And please do comment and share this video. I would love to start a discussion with you on the subject of colorization and anything else Photoshop. I think I'll see you on the next one.